Good morning. I have a few questions for the Board Secretary Di Benadera. Can you give us an update, ma'am? Can you give us an update on the cases filed against the Apatuans in connection with the massacre of the 7 people, especially journalists? Because last week, 25 counts of murder have been filed against Andal Jr. Are we expecting more this week, and how many Apatuans would be implicated or will be charged in court? Because I think apart from Andal Jr. and Senior, there were other names that were mentioned, like Badalin, Ulo, Norge, and Ahmad Jr. So may we also ask General Versosa and General Caro, where are these people are now? And for Secretary Puno, you created a task force to look into the finances of the armed and the provincial government. Have you found any evidence to show that people's money, public funds, were being used to buy these weapons or to bribe officials and prosecutors and judges to influence the cases? Let's take you.
Okay. Let me first deal with what are the cases pending right now. You have to distinguish two cases. There is an information filed against Mayor Unsay of Patuan, because remember, he was arrested and we conducted the inquest, and therefore he is detained until now. There are also two policemen who were arrested by PNP, and now we did an inquest, and the cases are filed in court. We have several others, like the other armed ones, but because it's no longer a hot pursuit, we have to go through the regular preliminary investigation. And what does it mean? We cannot just arrest them. They have to avail, we have to give them the due process of the law, which is really go through a preliminary investigation, the usual subpoena, the usual counter affidavit. And that's the reason why, despite the naming of the other Ampatuans, they are not being detained. So these are the two things. And in terms of having just 25 counts, because we go by evidence at that time, the proof of death that we had in our possession just referred to about 25 people. Now that we are nearing completion towards the 60 people, 60 victims, then we shall be submitting all this to the prosecutors. The PNP has been submitted.
When are we expecting additional murder charges to be filed?
Okay. Under the law, because this is a regular preliminary investigation, the Department of Justice, the prosecutors, we have 60 days to complete the process, barring any delay caused also by legal processes.
Can we not use the martial law to arrest these people?
Remember, we go by the rule of law. When it comes to murder, we have to follow the rule of law. There is they have to go through the preliminary investigation. For the rebellion, they can be arrested. But when we do file the charges for rebellion, because they were arrested under martial law, then they will have to be accused of rebellion. So there's a difference. Now, under martial law, they are detained without the warrant. And because rebellion is also punishable by reclusion perpetua, then it is also non-bailable. And therefore, they will remain to be incarcerated.
Oh, what's your most damning evidence against the Ampatuan? On the massacre and the rebellion?
For the rebellion, as I said, you have to forgive me that I'm not able to put it out today, right this moment, because the inquest will be done any moment today too. Now, for the murder, we have people who were in that area. We also have participants, and these are the witnesses that we have.
What did they say?
When it comes to the murder, because I have seen it personally.
Is it true that Andal Jr. Parties gun?
At some victims, that is the account of some of the